massive. So today I'm going to go to the concentrates on the cable. I think the cable, you've added some of the impacts. That's what saves you in infections, health experts, et cetera. Some of the tools that people there. We've got a forum coming together now, and I'll go back to that. And Steve's asked us to do another show, Margaret and I have discussed this. We don't want to be mainstream sources of the colour that's had to run away and try about the future. So that's all the LCRCA bands, right? So obviously, since the leaders have all been there as well. But I'd like to be particularly sensitive, you know, because we've had issues about the past. This particularly, we've done a huge thing. Every single adult is staff is hands. Margaret, she's my today colleague, and Liverpool colleague, children's services, well, that's asking another figure. And when you start looking at some of the numbers on that, this is a figure up there, it's not, it's just a figure. It's not about 1.5, it could even be £2 billion funding gap for the process of aging. That's what we've got. We've got an increase in demand because our demographics are getting bigger each year. We've got our population failing. We've got markets failing because some of the providers out there can and often do walk away from contact with the so we're looking at places that's less than half the future. And the system is all over the place and we've got to do something about that as quickly as we can. Hence, having the forum and getting the Concordat forum so we can drive this forward. But not Manchester. We didn't do what Manchester wants us to do. Yeah, the States. But we wanted to take our time, scope it out, and learn some lessons from that, and then drive some ideas forward. Within that, I'm looking personally looking at each area, we'll have a local plan to deal with their health. We've attracted £1 million external funds just to get where we are now. The joint delivery system, we have a system in Knowsley that wasn't compatible with all the areas. All that data is collected together now. We can actually work out how good care homes are in this particular area and how much it costs that and where the benefit of efficiencies can be found out from that. We're working on that and things like that. Again, I've mentioned earlier, we've done the collaboration side of it. We've worked on that. It's about the personalities now. There's some really, really good people in there. And there's some, particularly from the NHS point of view, what they're trying to drive with the SCP is toxic to as members. And we've got to drive that. There's some good stuff within that. But we need to be very, very mindful of when they talk about, say, reconfiguration, we, politically wise, will have no part of that. I mean, that will get together. I want to that out there straight away. We understand that there's reasons behind it all, but they've got to come and join us at the table and not just say we're doing that for you. We've got to be part of that discussion along with what we're calling the general public. I think I've covered pretty much all that one. So, okay. We've set up as a test case, South Park's domain between ourselves, and Seth. And this is to drive some of them market demands out the window and get some even more efficiencies out of that. We're working again with our communities and with the assessment standards. But for me, it's not just about that, it's the whole system. First thing I see just mentioned from that is that it's everything we do, it's a whole wraparound system that we're trying to build there. And how can we help with that? So when we talk about skills and training and opportunities, that's what fills that. If you look at the background of that, I think like the GBA for the health economy in the 60s is about 4.5 million people. So there's a massive amount of money that we can spend inside for. Again, I want to work with the NHS. I think we should work with the NHS. We've had various meetings with them. Some of them have been good meetings, and some of them to be honest with you, have been slow. But we need to drive forward. I've been talking to other colleagues for St. Helens yesterday. And we're looking at the footprints, how we want to engage best with our CCGs, how we actually want to drive that forward. But some of the numbers that you can bring out of that, we want to enable people to stay on for longer, because that's the benefit to them and to us to stay on the same. We've got down about £38 million that we can't possibly get out of the scheme anyway. We want to reduce the residential placements by at least 30%, less than the placement by 10%. Then there's just figures that we're working towards at this moment in time. I'd like to increase them. But it's about learning the lessons, and it's about over the last 2 years since I've been living here, is that we're starting to talk more and more as local authorities. We're starting to understand these individuals' point of view and where we're going with them. And more importantly, I think we're starting to get some hand up. We're all on the same bus, all on the same way. And that's what we need to do. I think that's pretty much all I've got to say. I'm not answering any questions today. But I will say this, when the next time we come up, I want to pick another because children's services is absolutely another massive piece of work. And I want to pay a little bit of tribute to colleagues that are doing that now. Liverpool and again, Sheffield College and Willow, we're celebrating it and agreeing with it that we can join children's services. And on a personal level, we've talked a lot, we've offered out to Willow, and we've been in that position before, I know exactly what's done. And that again is what that collaborative approach. It's not one person talking about what.
Thanks, Abby. Excellent. As the